Hi, I'm Gordon from Camera Labs, and this is Sony's FE 400mm f2.8 G Master, the first bright super telephoto lens designed for its alpha mirrorless cameras. This is an unashamedly high-end lens aimed at pro sports photographers and a perfect pairing with the A9 body. It's also a very important lens for Sony as it finally allows them to pitch the alpha mirrorless system as a really serious rival to Canon and Nikon for pro sports and wildlife photographers, the kind of people who demand big telephoto lenses with very large apertures. I got to try out the lens at a Sony event, and in this video I'll share my results. If you'd like to hear all my news direct from official events, just hit that subscribe button. Thanks. Now on with the video. So for starters, here's how the 400mm f2.8 lenses from Canon, Nikon and Sony look next to each other, on the left side without their lens hoods, and on the right with their lens hoods fitted. You can see they're all roughly similar in size, and they're also in a similar ballpark for price. You're looking at around $10,000 for the Canon, $11,000 for the Nikon, and $12,000 for the Sony. So at its launch RRP, the Sony is more expensive, but it's also substantially lighter. At 2895 grams, or 6.4 pounds, it's almost a kilogram or 2 pounds lighter than its rivals, a difference which becomes even greater when you pair them with their respective professional bodies. I found I could actually handhold the Sony combination for short periods, whereas the Canon and Nikon versions went straight onto a monopod after only a few seconds. All three lenses may sport large front elements, but Sony's optical design is more complex with 23 elements in 17 groups, which include 3 fluorite elements to minimise chromatic aberrations. Sony reckons it's sharper in the corners than its rivals, and by grouping most of the elements towards the middle, it also feels better balanced with their lighter bodies. You especially notice this when swinging the lens around to follow action. The lens features a selection of buttons near the mount, at the top a switch for auto and manual focus, and next to it one that enables full-time manual focusing even when the camera's set to AF. Below this is a focus limiter switch with 3 ranges, the full range, 7m to 2.7m, and infinity to 7m. Below this is a switch that lets you configure the twistable function ring that's next to the main focusing ring. You can preset a fixed distance and jump to it immediately with a twist of this ring, handy for returning to the start or a key position in a race perhaps, or maybe to a bird's nest or a branch that it's using for hunting. You can alternatively set one of 2 functions to this ring that I'll show you in just a moment, or simply disable it if preferred. Below this are the controls for the optical steady shot stabilization, which has 3 modes: general purpose, panning only, or a third one for unpredictable motion. Oh, and that beep switch at the bottom is to toggle the focus preset confirmation. Towards the end of the barrel is a wide manual focusing ring that turns very smoothly. There's also 4 focus lock buttons positioned around an outer ring which can be configured with a single function from the camera menus. I set mine to eye detection. Finally, there's the thin programmable function ring in between which twists back and forth with a spring-loaded action. This can be set to jump to a preset focusing distance or to select one of 2 functions which I'll show you right now. If the camera has been firmware updated to support this lens, and at launch it'll just be the A9 with others hopefully to follow, you'll see a new menu option to configure the function ring between power focus and the APS-C crop mode. When set to power focus, twisting the function ring will smoothly rack the focusing until you let go. This is designed for video use when you want to pull focus smoothly but not use the camera's autofocus system to do it for you. In practice, I found it quite hard to stop at the desired point without overshooting a little bit, but peaking and practice will of course help, plus of course you can still either use autofocus or the manual focusing ring in video. Set the function to APS-C crop and a twist of the ring will switch the camera between full frame and APS-C crop modes. This lets you very quickly punch in and out again, effectively giving you a 1.5 times additional zoom without having to go through all the menus. Doing so on stills obviously reduces the resolution, and for a 24 megapixel full frame body like the A9, you'll drop down to 10 megapixels when you're in the crop mode. You could also, of course, just crop your images later, but if you're a sports photographer who has to quickly deliver finished images, it really can save you time. Like most super telephoto lenses, there's no front filter thread. It would be enormous. Instead, smaller filters are fitted internally at the back using a rear insert. The 400mm f2.8 features a built-in tripod foot with a collar that allows the lens to rotate within. The foot features 3 threads, but no groove for direct arc or Swiss mounting. Again, like most super telephoto lenses, the 400mm f2.8 is supplied with a substantial lens hood, which fixes in place with a screw, and can also reverse over the barrel for transportation. The lens hood has a rubber ring around the front edge, allowing you to stand it up securely when not in use. Again, like most super telephoto lenses, the lens cap is more like a mini pouch that pushes over the end of the hood and hooks around the tightening screw. You can't really use it without the hood fitted, but the hood itself is so substantial that it will give you a great deal of protection even without the cap fitted. The lens also comes with a comfortable padded strap that's designed to loop through lugs on the side of the lens barrel itself to accommodate its heavier weight. Okay, now for some shots I took with the FE 400mm f2.8 on an A9 body. I'm going to start with portrait shots, as while the long focal length means you'll need to be further away than normal, you can still get some great results, whether street style from a distance or head and shoulders from just a few meters. All of these were taken at f2.8 and it's clear how easily you can blur that background. Like all G Master lenses, Sony's proud of its rendering of blurred areas, and thanks to eye detection, it's easy to ensure the main subject is pinned sharp. Oh, I should add that these are all JPEGs out of camera too. Sorry for not shooting you in RAW, Jared. Like its Canon and Nikon rivals, the closest focusing distance is around 2.7 meters, which sounds quite far, but at 400mm still lets you get fairly tight onto the subject. All of these shots were taken close or actually at the minimum focusing distance, where the depth of field is shallowest of all. You can really obliterate the background here. I'm also fond of using super telephotos to capture tighter views of city scenes. If you're shooting over a long distance, you have to be careful about losing resolution due to atmospheric disturbance, especially during a hot day, but if the conditions are right, you can enjoy lots of details. These views of Manhattan at night from across the Hudson River and Hoboken are packed with fine details right up to the corners, even though they were shot at the maximum aperture of f2.8. Clearly, Sony's G Master promise of sharp details across the frame have been fulfilled for this model. I also tried out the lens for video, here actually handheld with the A9, something which I wouldn't be comfortable doing with the Canon or Nikon versions. And I used the A9's wide area mode with face detection to track these cyclists as they approached me. Now, portraits, landscapes and macro photography may be fun bonuses for this kind of lens, but the primary purpose of a 400mm f2.8 is for pro sports. So Sony organised press passes for a bunch of us to shoot an MLS match at pitch level in the Red Bull Stadium, where the New York Red Bulls were playing against FC Dallas. On the night, I shot mostly with Expand Flexible Spot to better isolate the players I wanted to focus on, and at the slightly reduced frame rate of 10 frames per second, where the A9 was already giving me more than enough images to choose from. The lens, with its new XD linear motor, really could focus tremendously fast, and driven by the A9, felt extremely confident. It could easily track players running towards me at top speed with a very, very high hit rate, even with my inexperience at football photography. I also tried shooting some slow motion with the A9 in 1080p at 120 frames per second, here slowed down by 4 times on my 30p timeline. The A9 can capture sound and continuously autofocus in 1080 120p, making it a very practical option for slow motion video. I should add, the Red Bulls won this match 3-0 and were very generous with fans afterwards, having a chat and signing lots of memorabilia, and I really enjoyed the fireworks display at the stadium afterwards too. The FE 400mm f2.8 is obviously a very specialist lens with a correspondingly high price tag, but while its launch RRP of $12,000 is $1,000 more than Nikon's or $2,000 more than Canon's, it does seem to outperform them in my tests so far. The optical quality is sharper right into the corners at f2.8, the focusing, driven by that linear motor, felt quicker, not to mention able to exploit the A9's focusing benefits, and there's no denying the appeal of a big lens that weighs 2 pounds or almost a kilogram less than its rivals. Put it this way, if you're about to drop 10 or 11 grand on a lens, it's not too much of a stretch to reach 12,000 for something that's lighter, faster, and arguably sharper too. Ultimately, Canon and Nikon still outgun Sony in sheer variety with fast 300, 500, 600 and 800mm lenses, but Sony's finally got a native bright super telephoto that showcases the A9's technology and which will delight pro sports photographers. It proves you can shoot pro sports with mirrorless and that Sony's taken the prospect very seriously. If you'd like to download my sample images at their full resolution for a closer look, head over to my reviews at cameralabs.com. And if you enjoyed this video, please like, comment, share, and of course subscribe too. And if you really like what I do, don't forget you can treat me to a coffee using the PayPal link in the description and comments. Thanks again for watching, and see you next time. Bye-bye.